So what's happening with our food supply? Let's look at our global fish production, because countries all over the world rely on the catch from the sea in order to feed their populations. And I want you to know that back in the 1960s, that the American government had a very optimistic view about how much food could actually be taken from the sea. In 1964, they wrote that the global harvest could be increased at least tenfold without endangering aquatic stocks. By 1967, they're saying, global harvest could be increased to 2 billion tons per year, when at the time, the global harvest was only about 60 million tons, an enormous increase. In the 1990s, our policy was still based on the assumption that there was essentially limitless amount of food to be extracted from the sea, when by then it was clearly obvious that we were never going to reach billions of tons of fish from the sea. And in fact, by 1989, global production outside China reached a maximum. If we add in the data from China, which a lot of people think are a bit suspect, but we'll include it anyway, growth stopped in the year 2000. Peak fish year was in the year 2000. And this peak, the most amount of fish that's ever been drawn from the sea, was only about twice 1964 harvests. So the American government was incredibly optimistic as what the world food supply might be. And it's really important to realize that this peak fish harvest is because the fisheries, the boats going out from all the different ports around the world, have been going around pulling out as many fish as they could, stripping out the most abundant areas, and then moving on. And the fish stocks have not recovered. So we really have reached a peak in production that will never be matched again. Let's think about a local scale. Let's look at an island again, like we did for the St. Paul reindeer. And let's look at the people on Easter Island. This is one of the most remote areas in the world. It's 2,000 miles from South America. It's 1,250 miles from the nearest habitable island in Polynesia, and that's where the Easter Islanders came from, in boats from further to the west in Polynesia. And they colonized in the years 400 to 800 AD. So they've been around for quite a long time. But the population peaked on Easter Island at about 9,000 individuals in the year 1550. In the year 1722, a Dutch admiral visited on Easter Sunday, hence it's called Easter Island to the Westerners, and he found only 2,000 people living in huts or caves and engaged in almost perpetual warfare. The population continued to decline after that, and conditions worsened. And all but 110 people were removed, actually evacuated in 1877. So Easter Island is a classic case of an ecological disaster caused by people. But let's look at it in detail. When Easter Island was first colonized around 800 AD, it was a tropical paradise. There were these Easter Island palm trees, fantastic, huge things that they used to build boats, and also as a source of food. There was also toromiro, another plant with edible fruit. One of the few quirks about Easter Island, though, was that there were no reefs near shore. People had to go further ashore to find any fish. For animal protein, they had to go out far from shore, catch porpoises and tuna. And to do this, they had to go out in very large canoes. Now, also Easter Island, you may actually be more familiar with Easter Island because of these huge statues that had been built there by the local people from hundreds of years ago. There are 887 of these large things. They're called moai, and they weigh tons. They're really hard to move around. 200 of them were erected in the 1500s, and they were planning on putting up many more and standing them around the island, but they never finished. A lot of these moai still lie in their quarries. Now, it's worth going into this because you see these big statues were so heavy they could only be moved on rollers, and these required really big logs. So they had to chop down trees, use their logs to roll the thing either like that. Some people say they rolled them like that, but either way, it took a lot of investment in timber to be able to move these things around. And demand for timber was so great that somebody had the bright idea to chop down the very last tree on Easter Island. Bad move, bad decision. So they couldn't make any more boats. They had to go out on a boat to get their porpoises and their tuna, but they couldn't do that anymore. So they had no more food from the sea. They started going to war. The most abundant source of meat now was other people. They became cannibals. And the island never recovered. This is an island. Viewed at the right scale, our globe is an island. No one leaves, nobody's coming in. We're all here. We have over 1 billion people on this planet. And as of today, I'm doing this in late 2013, the Earth's population will increase by 214,000 people. That means we're going to be adding within a month almost 7.5 million people. That's bigger than the size of the population of the state of Minnesota. What to do?